वेलकम बैक टू कार मैकेनिक सिमुलेटर एंड यू आर वॉचिंग श्लोक 1327। नाउ आई नो दैट इट्स बीन अ मोर देन मंथ दैट आई वॉज ऑन अ ब्रेक गिविंग सम टाइम टू माई करियर। सो नाउ आई एम बैक एंड देर वुड बी अ लॉट ऑफ वीडियोज कमिंग ऑन। एक्चुअली आई डोंट नो इफ पीपल लाइक माई वीडियोज और नॉट। So let's start again. So today I will show you this. This is a Shelby Daytona Coupe. This thing was made by Carroll Shelby and its team to beat the Ferrari 250 GTO. Now also I also have that car which I will show you in the later episode. So first I will show you why this thing exists in its first place. So the reason why the Shelby Daytona Coupe exists is this. This is a Shelby Cobra 427. I don't know if you have watched this car. I have showed this car in my earlier episodes. So Shelby Cobra was the first car that was created by legendary Mr. Carroll Shelby. The chassis was taken by AC Cobra and engine was borrowed from Ford. It was a great sports car. First it had a 289 small block engine, then this 427 big block engine. It was a great sports car and it did win many FIA championship races. But when it comes to Le Mans race, this thing had a top speed of 160 mile an hour. And because this thing does not had a top, it is not aerodynamically very good for the Mulsanne straight, where the Ferrari 250 GTOs were getting speed above 180 mile an hour. This thing was good for 160 miles an hour. But it was bad above 160. So Carroll Shelby and Peter Brock used as a base this Shelby Cobra to create this Shelby Daytona Coupe. It was a totally redesigned structure. And created this in its first plates. Now as you can see, this is a very aerodynamic car. It was stable above 180-190 miles an hour, and it did also beat the Ferrari 250 GTO. Also it did win Sebring, Daytona and Le Mans in its class. That's why it is named Shelby Daytona Coupe. So now the role of Shelby Cobra is complete. Let's get it into the parking lot. So now I will show you the engine of this Shelby Daytona Coupe. So this car actually only comes with the Ford 289 cubic inch small block V8 engine, which produces 300 horsepower at stock. But as I have used the aftermarket parts, which I always use, that includes aftermarket 4 barrel carburetors, परफॉर्मेंस इनटेक एंड एग्जॉस्ट मैनिफोल्ड्स, फोर्ज पिस्टन्स. ऑल्सो वी हैव गॉट परफॉर्मेंस इग्निशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर. And performance clutch plates and camshafts. So we will see the horsepower number at the dyno. So this car really handled well at the Le Mans racetrack thanks to its independent front suspension and also independent rear suspension, multi-link rear suspension. Also, it has a 5-speed manual gearbox. So if we talk about tires, these are slick tires, 245 45 R16 in the front and 315 45 R16 in the rear. Now these tires are wide, same as the GT40s. So this is it for the powertrain. Also you can see spare tire in the trunk of this Shelby Daytona coupe. So now I will show you the interior. So the interior looks same as the Shelby Cobra, 4-speed manual gear shifter, and these switches are for the fuel pump and ignition, wooden steering wheel, tachometer which goes up to 200 mile an hour. So this car was the first win by Carroll Shelby against the Italians. Also this is a very rare car, only 6 of them were produced. So now we will go to dyno to see the horsepower improvement. Also this car came with white stripes which are not available in this game. So as you can see, this thing produces 450 horsepower with 790 newton meters of torque. So it has an improvement of 150 horsepower, which is good for this aerodynamic sports car. It will help to reach the speed above 200 mile an hour barrier. So now we will go to racetrack to see how it drives. So as you can see, acceleration is amazing. And it is a great handling sports car. So now we'll go to drag strip to see if we can go above 300 kilometers per hour or not. So now you have seen this Shelby Daytona coupe on both racetrack and drag strip. Now I don't know why it was not able to go above 300 kilometers per hour. Maybe it was some gearing issue, gear ratio issue. The top speed was 287 kilometers per hour, which equates to 180 mile an hour. Anyway, still it is a very fast and rare car. So this is it for the video. Also let me know in the comments about your thoughts on this Shelby Daytona coupe. I salute to Mr. Carroll Shelby. Stay tuned, more videos will be coming in. Thanks for watching. See you next time.